James Whitlock. He's a member of the Lacrosse Beekeepers, and he has bees in Mississippi and in California. And he takes them to California for pollinating, and then after pollinating, the ovum and so on, he brings, well, he splits them and so on, takes off packages and so on. I'm sorry, nukes. A nuke means a nucleus. And a hive has 10 frames in it. A nucleus or a nuke has just five. It's just half a five box of bees. So they call it a nuke. And if you have a laying queen, you have the everything that you have later on with bees. You have the larva, you have the pupa, eggs, and go on and on. Either four or five frames, and the frame is this is not as deep as it's a line for the whole split, but anyhow, this is the frame, and it would be deep, so it's a little bit deeper than this. And so it would be four or five of those. And if there's only four frames, he is charging $100. Now, when you get these, you take those these frames out of the nuke. Now, Jim Whitlock, he said that he buys cardboard nukes. Usually they're wood one, but he can get the cardboard one. So he has the four frames in there with a laying queen and several frames that already have the pupa, larva, and so on. Put them in time, and you fill it out the rest with your own frames. Question?
Okay, maybe I'm getting the terminology then wrong, but you get four or five of those frames, but you still presumably have to have the box ready to go to put the frames in. That's a true statement, yeah.
Okay.
So how much would the box be? So if it's $100 for essentially half a hive.
I'd just like to get this order of business to you so you understand what you have to be looking at. Now, with the nukes, they won't be here until the middle of May, he said. But they are all set to go. Now, the ones, if you get just packages, and one of those are going to be in April. And so, the queen is separate, and so then you have to get them in the box, and then the queen will start laying, and depending, it'll take a little while if you're beginning from scratch with all the new equipment. And so the advantage to the nuke is that you really have a head start, I think. The one thing that worries me a little bit about this, and I think you can check and make sure, Oscar was the one that contacted him, and is that he said that he's going to have 300.
Now, I asked him what the minimum number that he could supply. And keep in mind that we're talking about this year and last year, but this year Bob tells us that they're going to supply us with fewer bees. Okay? Whitlock, he had one person last year that I sent to him that got a nuke. The person says, I don't want packages, I want a nuke. And I said, Jim Whitlock has them. Well, Jim told me that he had purchased the nukes. Jim said, I can guarantee they are laying queens. The nice thing about it is that when you get a nuke, you've got the laying queen. She's been with that group all the time in that box. The package you have, as you mentioned as I'm showing you the package, they get the package of workers from one hive, and the queens are in a bank. People know how to raise them by the thousands, and then that queen's put in a cage. She's unrelated to those workers. Now, they have to get used to her, and that happens in the shipment from California in 2 days that they're being shipped. They get the smell and the like and so on, and when she's released, I've not had a problem where one has been killed under those circumstances. We put them together because they've been together for a couple of days. they're ready to accept it. She's ready to lay in a couple of days. But with this other one, that queen has been with her all that time. She's kind of an advantage.
Question, so you can buy bees, 2 pounds, 3 pounds, and you have how many bees coming? How many bees coming?
I wouldn't be able to answer that. But I would, I'll just hazard a guess. There'll be more than you would have on the 2 pounds. Probably, I'm going to guess around 3 pounds. I really don't know. Because when you've got 4 or 5 frames, and at least 2 of them are with brood, egg larva, and pupa, you're going to have a good number of bees. And I would say it would come very well to one of them.
With the nuke, you're going to have all stages of development in there. So you're going to have some, again, we're kind of ahead of the story, but you're going to have what's called cap brood. That's where the bee goes into the pupa stage. And so you're going to have some of that, and you're going to have bees that will hatch shortly, maybe even while you're getting them. And so the only thing that I am being concerned about, and I think we can pin him down, would be that he said that if a commercial beekeeper wanted all of his, that he would sell them to him. But I think that if we got some major orders in.
But I would say you are, let's say 100% sure that you're going to do the bees, and you want to go with the nukes, you're going to have to travel over to Rushford, Minnesota, to get them. But, and we aren't going to do that for you, but you're going to have to go over and get them. You're going to deal with Jim. You've got his fits, cell phone number, and his landline. And Jim has had some knee problems. I was talking to him. He was in a nursing home and had knee surgery. But he says, I'll be out there, and he worried. But I'm pretty worried about that part of it. But if you're going to order for him, I would not wait too long, because what I'm about to say to you, he's not going to say, okay, you've got the order, but I've got these others. I'm sure that he'll be committed to getting rid of the bees. I'm fairly positive that he'll be that honest with them. I think he's many, many years. So, good question.
Yeah, so if we didn't buy a new, okay, comes in mid-May, you said somewhere around there?
Yes.
We often go on vacation for 2 weeks in late May, in the first part of June. Once I get them in the box, is there anything I have to do with them in those first couple of weeks? Or?
No, I think if you plan just a little bit ahead, put a little bit more space for them.
Some extra room,
You don't want to get too far ahead of them.
Right.
But in 2 weeks, with a new, you probably want to give them a little more space.
And it sounds like, and I'm not necessarily promoting nukes, I do think that this is a really good deal if he won't renege on the delivery. But I mean, it's fairly close, and maybe there's where you can get together and somebody can go and get a pickup load or something. And they have a head start. Now, the package bees come earlier, and then if you're starting from the beginning, in a few minutes, Oscar will talk about that. You have all new equipment. You have what we call foundation, and they have to build that out. We'll show you if we don't get lost someplace. Show you what that is. And so they have to build that out, and before the queen can lay eggs, all she'll start before the cell is complete. And so,
I'm no expert at all on this. I started my trial in there last year. But one of the errors I got into was waiting too long to order my package. And there is an end point of when they'll stop taking orders. I don't know when that was. I did my package through B&B, and they were just excellent. But
But I was like, well, we closed last week, I'll see if I can get this on. So if you're thinking about it, call them up and get your order in, because there is an endpoint to when they don't take orders.
We had one person sitting in the class, so I can talk about it, that ordered everything and so on. The bees he got at the end of the month. And when he got them, the queen wasn't a good queen. Queen was running all over. She was laying eggs, so she was not mating. But she this queen, I never went into anything like this. She was just running away from everybody. And they, the other bees wanted to be with her and protect her and all that sort of thing. And she was going all over the place. But I don't know where this fellow's place, because as you come over, I'm over. I said, okay. I said, you've got a queen that's not laying eggs. She's not going to be with her. There's a Gorda B&B at Houston, Minnesota, Top Hollow Road. And I said, go up by a queen. Come back. And the queen is in a cage with an attendant. I says, get that queen so you can go and have a queen. Find that queen that's running around. She's going like this. They hate to do that. Squeeze her to death. And then put the other queen in, but you leave her in that little queen cage for about 2 or 3 days. Usually those come with a little candy on the one hand, and what you do is the cork, the candy, you take the cork out, and then the worker bees will leave the candy out. By the time they've got the candy eaten out, the queen is accepted. She smells the same, or they smell like her, or whatever smells like whatever. Anyhow, he released quite nicely. He did what I said. And then, of course, he got past the nectar time. He said, what do I do? I said, well, we're not going to have honey this year. So I said, if you want to keep these bees, I said, you're going to have to feed them a lot of sugar water. And I said, otherwise, watch them in the middle of what happens in the fall. So he poured sugar water to them. And he told me recently that they were still living. He says, I put my ear up to the hive and I could hear them. It's just more than I put my and I put it up and we could hear the bees humming inside of the hive, which is kind of fun to hear. Okay? So I would, if you want to go to news, contact Jim Woodhart, but don't wait too long. I'm quite sure he would
We don't have, you know, is there an address or there's no phone number?
No.
Oh, yeah, there's phone numbers?
No,
okay.
No.
Not down there? Okay. Okay. You want maybe a phone number?
Yep.
Okay. So his home phone number is 507-875-2725. Okay. Now, the other is a cell phone, and he says sometimes a cell phone, depending where it's at, may be a little bit static and so on, but the cell phone is 507-450-0157. Okay, so we're contacting him. We're not going through us. I'm not getting paid anything on this. Doing this with Jim says he has them. And Bob says the packages, they're cutting down from last year.